Greetings, friends. David Marks here. Today, I have a tutorial for you on the new content-aware remove tool inside of Adobe Photoshop Lightroom Classic version 12. Before we get rolling, let me point out that you will not find this brand new feature inside of older versions of Lightroom. If you have not upgraded to Classic version 12 yet, then unfortunately, this tutorial is not for you. With that quick warning out of the way, let's jump right in and let's get started. For our first example, I want to show you a type of photography where the new content-aware remove tool can be a big help. When professional-grade interior shots get published, it's standard procedure to make the walls look as pristine as possible. Pristine here means that most of the light switches and all of the electrical outlets will be removed from each photo in post-processing. So to clean this image up, I'm going to zoom way in. I'll go to 200% view. And then I'm going to activate Classic's Healing Tools panel. When this panel opens, you might notice that we've got some new icons up here in Classic version 12. The option furthest to the left, the one that's currently active, is the new Content Aware Remove tool. But before I start to use this tool, I'm going to set its size to something that's a little bit larger than one of these electrical outlets. Next, I'm going to double check that this tool's opacity is set to 100%, and then I'll paint a brush stroke right over this outlet. Bam! The outlet vanished, and that's pretty neat. Before I attack the next one to the right, I'm going to make my brush a little bit larger. From what I've seen, the new content-aware remove tool produces superior results if you paint with a brush that's a bit larger than the flaw that you're trying to remove. To change the brush size, I can come back up here to the Healing panel on the right and move this slider around, but there are two easier methods. One way to increase the brush size of any brush tool in Lightroom Classic is to tap on one of the bracket keys on your keyboard. The right bracket key on your keyboard increases the brush tool size, and the left bracket decreases it. The other easy way to change your brush size is to roll the scroll wheel on your mouse up or down. That looks about right, so now I'll paint over this outlet too. In no time, it'll vanish. Before I start working on the next outlet, I'm going to check on the quality of my work by tapping on this little light switch at the bottom of the healing panel. With this off, I can see a before and an after. The work I've done so far looks good, so now, let's go after the next set of outlets. Here, I'm going to start with the cursor a bit higher than you might think. One of the things that I found in my testing is that the outer ring that you see on the screen here, that outer ring is not an accurate indicator of the actual brush size that you're dealing with when using this tool. What I'm trying to say is don't worry if the outer ring of the cursor seems too far away from the flaw. It's the tiny crosshair in the middle of the brush symbol that matters most. So I want to start this repair with that little crosshair positioned a bit above the object that I actually want to remove. Despite having a big enough brush this time, you can see that the results here are a failure. The problem is that the content-aware remove tool uses some form of Adobe's proximity match algorithm. And in this case, that proximity match formula is automatically selecting a piece of the outlet that is mounted on the wall to the right of the area that I'm trying to remove. Mistakes like this, where the proximity match selects the wrong area to sample, are common with this tool. But fortunately, the brilliant minds at Adobe have given us an easy way to deal with these failures. To change where this algorithm goes looking for the pixels that it will invent for our patch, I can hold down the Command key on a Mac or the Control key on a PC. With the Command key held down, I can drag a rectangle out over here, over this region of blank wall, to define the source that I want the algorithm to use to cover my flaw. In this case, that worked great, but if it doesn't immediately improve things, then try using the Command click again and again to select different areas of your image. Usually, it only takes me a couple of tries with the Command-Click trick to create a better match. Another trick that can be helpful when you're evaluating your work is to hide the tool overlay away. By tool overlay here, I mean the little ring and these symbols that show us all the places where we've used some variety of the healing tool set. To hide these markers, tap the letter H on your keyboard. Hiding these overlays away temporarily can help me see where I've done good work and where I might need to make additional improvements. Things look great here, so I'm going to tap on the letter H on my keyboard to bring those overlays back. Now, let's get rid of the next wall covering. Again, I think I can do better if I use that Command or Control and drag feature to define a better source. Now, I could attack the last of these light switches along the right side of the wall, and I would if this image were really going to be published, but I think you get the point. Instead of repeating what you've already seen, let me close the healing panel, and now let me show you a complete before and after for this image. With very little work, we've gone from this, where the wall looks cluttered, to this, where the kitchen looks nice and clean. That was pretty painless. So next, let's hop over to a completely different type of image, where the new Content Aware Remove tool also produces really pleasing results. Like cleaning up an architecture photo, it's considered professional to hide dog tags and collars when you're doing high-end pet portraits. In this case, I was taking photos of my dog Bella, and I forgot to remove her dog tags before I started shooting. So let's see what we can do to remove these flaws without leaving Lightroom Classic. To attack this problem, I'm going to open up the healing panel again, and then I'm going to activate the Content Aware tool. Next, I'm going to increase my brush size using the scroll wheel on my mouse. Since the opacity for this tool is still set to 100%, I'm ready to paint. It's not perfect, but I have to admit that Classic did a good job here, inventing a patch of new fur to cover over the area that I don't want to see in this image. To improve things, I could use the Command or Control drag trick to set my own sampling point, but there is another option. If I want to force Lightroom to find another sample for its patch, but I don't want to bother defining that area to use myself, then I can come up here to the bottom of the healing panel and tap on this refresh button. Each time that I tap this button, I'm telling Classic to sample a different area and to create a different patch. Sometimes the second or third attempt is better, and sometimes it's worse, but it's worth knowing that if your initial attempt is not perfect, then you can force the algorithm to try again without having to start all over. The keyboard shortcut for the refresh command while this panel is open is the forward slash key on your keyboard. To be clear, the forward slash key on a US keyboard is the one where the top edge of the slash line is angled towards the right. I think that this patch is as good as I'm going to get, and for some folks, this would be good enough. Since I'm a bit of a perfectionist when it comes to image cleanup, though, I want to show you one more trick. To do this, I'm going to close the healing panel for a second, and now I'm going to open up the healing panel again. But this time, I'm going to activate the clone tool option. With the clone tool active, I'm going to set the feathering to about 90%. And now, I'm going to drag out a circle over here. I'm intentionally going to set my cloning up a little bit away from the area that I actually want to remove. Next, I'm going to move this circle, the paste into end of my clone patch, over top of the area where I already used the Content Aware tool. Now, I can move the other side of the equation, the copy from part around, until I find some fur that's a great match. I'll do this one more time to make things even better. But this time, I'm going to adjust the opacity of my clone stamp so that the patch I'm creating will blend in a little bit more with the pixels that are underneath it. That looks good. So now, let me close this panel, zoom back out, and now I'll split my screen so that you can see a full side-by-side comparison. On the left is the image that we started with, and on the right is the cleaned-up version. My experience with the Content Aware Remove tool is that it often works fairly well on its own, but don't forget that this tool is not meant to exist in a vacuum. When Content Aware fails, try defining a new area for your patch, or try combining it with some of the other tools that we already have in Lightroom Classic. On lots of images, those techniques are going to give you good results. But if you find an image where you just can't get good results, then always remember that there is so much more that you can do to remove things from your images using the full Adobe Photoshop. I hope that you found this video helpful. If you learned something today, then please hit the subscribe button and leave us a like or a comment down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.